I'd like to preface this video that the photocard shown in this video was bought specifically for the purposes of that, showing them off and showing the differences between real and fake cards. I do not encourage anybody go out and buy unofficial cards as they are a form of theft, but if you want to, I cannot ban anybody from doing anything that they want with their money. But they are a form of theft, and I highly advise that you do not buy them. Trading cards are a huge part of a lot of fandoms. Countless TV shows, video games, and sports teams have trading cards associated with them. In the K-pop fandom, photocards have become somewhat of a trading card-like. Trading cards don't have to have a playable value, as collecting aspect is a game in itself. Unlike Magic the Gathering or Pokemon, trading cards, K-pop photo cards aren't a game, more like football or basketball game cards. When it comes to collecting K-pop photo cards, it can be hard, especially in the beginning, because unlike other collecting trading cards that usually come in packs of six for $2 or $3, K-pop photo cards come one at a time in albums or DVDs that go for $15 to $50. Many of us turn to sites like eBay, Yahoo Auctions, and Facebook Marketplace for our cards. With that, there's a certain risk. Many K-pop photo cards are faked and sold as real. Many new K-pop card collectors may or may not know where and what to buy, and if the seller is trustworthy, and if the cards are authentic. In this video, I will be showing you guys the difference between real and fake cards, and what are some red flags when looking at your cards, and what are some red flags when looking at the seller you're buying from on eBay and Facebook Marketplace. First and foremost is knowing if your seller is trustworthy. When buying a Facebook Marketplace, most trading and selling Facebook groups will have an admin-pinned master list of scammers. These scammers can be called scammers for different reasons, such as wasting your time, not responding to your messages, selling fake photo cards, or even sending empty packages. Before buying from a seller, I would recommend scrolling through the master list and checking if that seller is on it. I would also recommend talking to the seller in detail before actually sending them any of your money and asking for proof of previous sales, proof of them having the photo cards, as sending new photos of the photo cards before you purchase. I will always tell anybody starting using Facebook, if they're using PayPal, to use gifts and services, as if you get scammed, you can get your money back. But when using friends and family, it's way harder to get your money back, as PayPal will not see this as a professional transaction. It will just see it as someone lending someone money. If you are unsure, always check the master list of scammers, ask for proof of previous sales, and use gifts and services. When it comes to eBay, there aren't many places where you can find lists of scammers, but there is a forum called photocards.boards.net that has a bunch of information about eBay sellers and about trustworthy and about scammers and about a whole bunch of things. I would always recommend looking at the person's reviews and looking at how long they've been selling, and looking if they have recent positive reviews and if the negative reviews overpower the positive reviews. I would also recommend reading the mutual room reviews, as many times they are negative reviews, but people don't feel comfortable leaving a negative review. Now you've gotten your card, but you're not sure if it's authentic. I want to get into knowing what the red flags of a card being bootleg or not is, and how the easiest is to tell the difference between a real and a fake card. Cards with rounded edges, loads of text, and pullout frames are going to be the easiest to tell the difference between real and fakes by the reasons I will get into in a bit. Specs is the number one thing any K-pop photo card collector will tell you to look out for. Specs are little dots on the rounded edges of photo cards that that are made from the mass production of the card. On fake cards, these specs will most likely be absent. I'd mention not all authentic cards do have specs, but most of them do have that have rounded edges. I would also like to add, because specs are mostly on cards with rounded edges, if you get a card that doesn't have any specs, also look at the shape of the rounded edge. If it's uneven, that is a big indicator that the photo card is fake, as uneven cards are not mass produced, because if they were uneven, they're going to be taken out of production and taken out of the alignment. Text is the next thing. Text on a photo card, signature, info on the back, etc. is very close to the edge of the card. That is a sign of being fake. Authentic cards are made equally and will not have text in odd places. Likewise, if a Polaroid frame is uneven or oddly placed, that is a huge sign of the card being fake. Text can also be blurry on fake cards. That is a very huge red flag, as it will be blurry as it's copied from the original card, and the quality of the text goes down by it being copied. Color and texture is the last thing you should look out for. When you get your card, do research on what the texture of the card is supposed to be like. Is it matte, glossy, or a mix of both? Likewise, you should try getting a high quality photo of the card and compare it to the original. I would also like to mention the thickness of the card is something you should also research, as many cards come in various thicknesses, and fake cards are not taken into account of how thick the card is supposed to be. For example, Park Bom's cards from her first album after her comeback are super thin, and a fake one might be just a regular thickness of the photo card. That is it for this video. I hope you guys did enjoy it and got everything out of it in your research on fake photo cards. I will be linking down below some videos by other creators on the same topic, so you can get everything you want out of this. If you didn't get it out of this video, you can get it in other videos. But yes, I will see you guys next time. Bye!